40 graces for 40 days. Dear friends in Christ Jesus, the whole world recognizes that this 40-day period is considered to be a special extended time. I believe the reason is that the number 40 is a very symbolic number in the sacred scripture. During the flood in the time of Noah, it rained for 40 days and 40 nights. After escaping from Egypt, the Israelites wandered in the desert for 40 years. Moses was on Mount Sinai for 40 days and 40 nights, waiting for the Ten Commandments. The Gospels of Matthew, Mark, and Luke tells us that Jesus spent 40 days in the desert fasting and praying after his baptism by St. John and in preparation for his public life. It is almost certain that it was this last episode which led the church to decide on the 40 days of Lent. Dear friends, Lent is a time for prayer. It is a time to take stock of our values, as a result of which we live our daily lives. We are living in a very secularistic world at present. It is said that technology has developed more in this century than it did since the beginning of time. I believe you can say that the grandparents of anybody who has reached the age of 80 or 90 never saw a motor car, an aeroplane, a radio, or a TV, and certainly never heard of the name Internet. But today, our lives are to a great extent governed by these technological wonders. In this time, how are we going to give time to the Lord? Lent is considered to be a spiritual season of calm, of reflection about the meaning of human life, of repentance for the errors and sins of humankind, of rejecting the temptations the world always offers, and also as a time to help the next person, be it neighbor or stranger, with actions of mercy and charity. Finally, Lent is a special time of year that allows us to place God first and worldly possessions second. It is a time to teach us that God is the most important, and these small sacrifices are nothing compared to the sacrifice that Jesus made. Through Lent, we become closer to God and hopefully more humble, God-like in our everyday lives. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, thank you for giving your life for our salvation. Lord, give us the grace to leave all the activities, habits, which is hindrance for our spiritual life. Lord, strengthen us so that we will be able to follow our Lenten plans. Amen. Sanctify yourself and you will sanctify the society, says St. Francis of Assisi. Have a grace-filled